Welcome to Chukchansi Park here in Fresno, California. You're in for a treat. We've got the Central Valley All-Stars game. I'm your host, Onesta Francis. Alongside me is Eric Barbosa. What kind of game are you expecting today, Eric?
I'm expecting a very, very high-scoring matchup. I mean, with these All-Star games, you're going to have a lot of talent. They're going to be goal-hungry, and I expect a lot of goals.
Looks like the American team in red, national team in black, American team coached by Eric Solberg from Fresno City College. National team coached by Alan Fortune from West Hills. National team applying some high pressure early on.
Yeah, and the good thing is that they're gelling pretty good right now. I mean, for only a half hour of practice, they're getting along well and looking to move the ball around.
Do you expect chemistry to be an issue here in the first half?
In the first half, yes. Probably within the first 10, 15 minutes, and they want to move the ball around. They want to get that feel to see what type of player they're playing with. But most of these players are familiar with each other, so it shouldn't be that much of a factor.
Any particular players that you think we should watch out for early on?
We got a lot of players on there. I believe we have the Fresno Bees all. He was All-Valley selection. I believe he's with the American team.
National team bringing it up. Lauren Friesen from Edison High School on the dribble. Looks to just slide the pass there just a little bit off. As again, we said earlier, it's going to take these players a little bit to find each other's passing rhythms and find those angles. American team building it up from the back. It's Jose Hernandez from Golden West with a beautiful crossfield pass. Looking for Alan Gonzalez from Hoover.
Yeah, you touched on that. That was a good ball. He sent him pretty well. Maybe the weather, maybe it's a little too hot out there, but that was a great ball.
Play broken up there by the national team. Cross coming in, dealt with easily. American team's got Fernando Uribe in nets from Orosi.
Yeah, Fernando's a good keep. Playing that ECR league, tough ECR league with Farmersville and McFarland. So he's one of the good ones.
What's his best attribute, you think, as a goalkeeper?
Just leadership. He commands that back line. And,
excellent through excellent ball. Puts the American team on the attack. But Austin Aguiar from Mount Whitney, quick off his line to deal with that.
Yeah, that was a good play, heads-up play.
Sorry to cut you off. You were talking about Fernando Uribe from Orosi.
No, he's just a good leadership guy, and all the intangibles are there. And I believe he's undecided.
Another great combination play. They are really looking to find that left side for the American team. I made a mistake. That's not Alan Gonzalez. That was Raymond Torres from Selma making those runs down the left.
And you can see they're gelling pretty good now. And they found a weakness on that back line.
Good tempo to the play in the first 3-4 minutes or so.
Oh, yeah. Very good tempo.
Frank Delena bursting down that right side, driving across over to Alan Gonzalez, holding off two or three defenders, looking to cut to that left foot before he's finally cut out. Frank Delena again on the ball out wide right. Cuts it to Lauren Friesen. Looks for the little scoop pass. Not quite there.
But again, that just tempo is picking up. And you're seeing the ball move out. You're going to be seeing a lot of runs, a lot of volleys.
Nathan Howard from Central High School playing it down the line to Alan Gonzalez. Alan, normally very nimble on the ball, just been caught in the dribble twice early. And there's a handball by Elijah Rodriguez from Sunnyside. Nathan Howard with a quick restart.
Good ball.
And Alan again with a shot, that time blocked. Scooped up by the American team. Fernando Uribe off to a good start so far. And these long diagonal balls seem to be a pattern for the American team style play. Do you think that's something that Coach Eric Solberg has put in the pregame talk?
Yes, as a matter of fact, I was down there before the game, and they were talking about sending the ball, getting a lot of possession, and when they seen an opportunity, they're going to send that ball. I think they found a weakness there where they're going to be lobbing the ball a lot.
Frank Delena, great intensity out of Memorial High School. He's on his way to Fresno State, where he'll actually be playing football there.
Nice. Yeah, too bad they don't got a soccer program there.
Oh, you know, that's definitely a big talking piece. What has to be done to bring that back?
Hopefully the new AD, Jim Barco, he brought wrestling back.
Oh, what a strike from the outside. Just goes out wide.
Another good thing about this is that they're getting coached by the college, the local JC coaches out here, and they're out there recruiting still, so most of these guys are going to get second, third looks.
Torres on that left side has been a handful already. But well spotted out by Jose Hernandez, yeah. Golden West right back. American team looking to switch the point of attack.
Nice switch.
Finding Elijah Rodriguez. Jason Ruiz from El Diamante on the overlap. One-on-one situation. Skips by Lauren Friesen. Delivers across far post. Nobody home.
Nobody home. That's a good ball. They always preach, always get that back post.
How many times have you heard coaches shout that?
Too many times. I mean, I shout it so many times. And it's one of those things where you're going to cost your goal.
You know, as we're saying, a lot of these guys been all-stars in high school, trying to make that next step into the college game. What do you think is the big step for most of these guys to transition their game into that college level?
I would say just the physicality. I mean, the skill set's there, the ball control, and now they're going to be with more mature men, how they're going to handle that, you know, the physicality, you know, the speed. But I think most of these guys are, you know, they play club ball, so they're used to it. They're used to that physicality, that style of ball.
Shot there from Elijah Rodriguez. Well wide, looked like he's trying to hit it with his weak or left foot.
Yeah, you see Coach Fortune out there with a little rag over his head. It's nice and toasty down there.
Yeah, it's hard being bald in these Fresno sun. And again, Alan Gonzalez from Hoover involved heavily in the attack in this first half. Ball just goes out of bounds. That'll be a throw-in for the American team. Throw-in cut out by the national team. Quick on the counter. Ooh. Gonzalez again with the outside strike. Good power. Fernando Uribe able to bring it in on the second touch.
Yeah, you can tell he just wanted to test the waters out, see if he's able to make a good save or not. But that was a nice little shot just to test him out.
Uribe might want to be careful blocking those shots and keeping them in bounds.
Got another through ball.
Cross comes in.
Oh, there it is.
And the finish. Sweet finish. From looks like Jorge Saldana from Riverdale. Excellent start to the game.
That was they're attacking that left side. And they got another through ball in there. Nice set piece.
You wonder if Coach Solberg saw something in the pregame talk, because they've been really attacking that left-hand side. Oh, on the replay, that might have gone out of bounds. Let's take one more look at that replay. And see, just as Sabatini gets to the cross, have been out of bounds.
I think you're right. I mean, you obviously see the other players.
Long ball coming through, quick bounce. Oh, and we'll get back to that replay as soon as we can, but right now we're in live action.
Going back to your point, though, I think they are attacking that left side quite frequently. I mean, I don't know if the players might be a little gassed or too slow, but they exploit it well.
I know Selma has been dangerous over these last couple of years. When they keep producing players like Raymond Torres, they're bound to be.
Oh, yeah. They have a great program down there. Central Sequoia League, really, really tough. And then they play with the likes of Dinuba, Kingsburg. You know, they're really tough. And he's really built a nice power there the last 3, 4, 5 years.
Throw in comes. National team looking to build it up slowly. Lauren Friesen knocks it back to Austin Aguiar. Austin Aguiar with a big boot forward. Again to Allen Gonzalez from Hoover. Frank DeLena, famous for that trademark Karate Kid headband.
Yeah.
Play comes out wide. Elijah Rodriguez knocks back Jason Ruiz. Looking for that slide rule pass. Cut out by Nathan Howard. A little bit of back and forth action here in the midfield.
Yeah, now they're just trying to fill each other out, trying to get that ball movement.
Nathan Howard's been an excellent defender for Central over these last couple of years. Just didn't quite see the chemistry there with Lauren Fries. I'm surprised they play club soccer together. You'd think that their chemistry would be on. Got a lot of good talent here on display today, Eric.
A lot of good talent, and I just love the way they're playing right now. They're really on the offensive. They're moving the ball well, and you got to get up to the coaches. I mean, to have only a half-hour preparation.
Excellent intensity there from Frank DeLena. You can see that he's got an aggressive spirit about his way he attacks the game.
He's going around.
Again, Ryan Arkelian from Buchanan looking to serve the ball in. American team on the break again. Again, Elijah Rodriguez seeing quite a bit of the ball.
Yeah.
You know, I think we're fortunate here with soccer in the Central Valley, one of the few sports where there's not much difference in the quality from Division 1, 2, 3, 4. You'll see quality players at every level.
You're exactly right. I think we are the only sport that parity doesn't matter if you're D6, like an Avenel, that Avenel team that always beats up on the Clovises, on the Buchanan. I mean, Buchanan's a tough squad, but I mean, they just compete so well, and that's all across the Central Valley.
American team very, very direct in this open half.
Yes, that was a nice little through ball.
We'll take this time to go over a little bit of the lineups for the American team. As we said, in red, coached by Eric Solberg. Ball delivered in. Recirculated back across. Oh. Elijah on the hustle. Can he finish it with the left foot? Tucks it away. Another sweet finish from the American team. They have came out like gangbusters today.
That was just a nice, nice play. I mean, he's been having the ball pretty much since we started, you know, the past 13 minutes, and they rewarded him with a nice goal.
Let's see the replay again. Again, direct play. Long ball sent in. Redirected. Does well to hold off the defender there. Mm-hmm. And then a sweet left foot finish to that near post. Very calm and composed even while the play was physical there. Nathan Howard looking for the long pass down the line. Do you think the national team can respond here?
I believe so. There's too much talent not to. And, you know, the soccer game's a roller coaster. You know, there's a lot of highs and lows. And they're not gelling right now, but they haven't had much ball, much possession. And there he is again, having ball.
All bouncing through the middle. Now, the tactics are different for each team.
Yeah, I mean, you see it right away. We got a lot of through balls with the American team. They're going to try to exploit you through the air. National team still trying to get a feel for the game.
American team starting in a 4-4-2, as we said, coached by Eric Solberg. Fernando Uribe from Orosi and Nets. Back line from left to right, Luis Salazar from Manachi. Kevin Bazulto from Selma. Christian Jimenez. We just pause to see if this play will break down into anything while bouncing around in the midfield. Excuse me, Christian Jimenez, Washington Union, playing center back for the American team, and Jason Ruiz on the right from El Diamante. Is the All-Star format more difficult for attacking players or defensive players, you think?
I think it's more so for the defensive players because you're going to have a lot of players play at not their natural spot. So, you know, not having that constant playing of the defender, it's going to be a little bit different. They don't know how they play, how they overlap.
Yeah, communication is crucial for defensive players particularly.
But again, you see the American is just on the offensive and they're getting all the loose balls.
Jason Ruiz serving the ball into the box, scooped up by Austin Aguiar. Continuing on with the lineups for the American side, they are playing a 4-4-2. The four mids across from left to right. Raymond Torres on the left, Esteban Salgado from Clovis North, and Jonathan Vasquez from Menachi in the center, and Elijah Rodriguez on the right. As we've seen, Elijah Rodriguez heavily involved here early.
Yes, heavy. And a lot of these players, I mean, most of these players are going to play on, and they're trying to get a spot with one of these coaches, and there's coaches in attendance, so they're trying to put on a show.
You know, Elijah Rodriguez, just another one of the good midfielders to come out of Sunnyside High School in the last few years.
We've got our first corner over there.
Go out of bounds. See if the national team can draw one goal closer with some good delivery here. Up top for the American team, Nick Sabatini from Clovis High, Jorge Saldana, who already scored from Riverdale. Cross coming in. Ball bounces out to Lauren Friesen from Edison. A little bit of a wild swing there. Going for the home run hit.
He didn't have – yeah, we're at Chukchansi Park. I think that's the wrong sport. But you can tell he didn't get a good chest down on that ball and got a little away from him.
I don't think American teams should give him too many more of those. Lauren, very technical striker of the ball. Oh, excellent header there. Ball bouncing back and forth, lands at the feet of Frank Delena, Memorial Zone, cuts into his right, looking for a little combination play.
Oh.
Ball doesn't quite bounce back out. Scooped up once again, Fernando Uribe.
Yeah, I think he was expecting a little give and go there, and I think he was open for a minute.
And again, those chemistry issues will work themselves out as the game goes along. Lauren Friesen again, seeing a lot of the ball in the middle of the field for the national team.
Nice ball.
Ball sprayed up top, out wide. Looks like Ryan Arkellian from Buchanan.
Nice, there it is.
Alan Gonzalez in the middle. It was a matter of time before those two linked up for a goal.
Yes, great move. And it started off with that nice midfield pass. Center mid, got it right down the line.
And we're in for a good match today. Yeah. You called it early on. You said it's going to be plenty of goals, open action, and that's exactly what we're seeing. Let's take a look at the replay as Alan Gonzalez just tucks away the nice, easy one with the left foot finish. Do you see the Heat playing a factor today?
I don't. I mean, they're used to playing in the Heat. I mean, I know it's a winter sport, but club ball, they play year-round. They play in the summer.
Most of these guys should be in good fitness, 18 years old. You've seen a lot of switching up for the three forwards from the national team. Now it looks like Allen's moved to the middle, Frank on the left, and Ryan Arkellian out wide. Oh, excellent cross pass there. Frank knocks it down for a strike.
Oh,
a laser bolt from Diego Banda.
That was a great shot. Again, they see something in that goalie that he's not going to try to contest those shots, so they're going to take their from 18, 20 wide.
Already seen a few players looking for a little water break.
Yeah, you're going to – they definitely got to get hydrated, plenty of water.
One of the factors with the Heat with being out here all day with the events and festivities beforehand, players got to remember to hydrate.
Yes.
Uribe with the ball cut out again by the national team.
And I can see the same style with the national team. They're attacking that right defender.
Yes, they're starting to open up. Look like they're going after Jason Ruiz. And Alan Gonzalez, another outside shot. He's definitely finding ways to get his shot off. He scored one. I won't be surprised to see him look for another.
Oh, yeah.
And I don't know if we've got an injury, but it looks like Fernando Uribe not taking the goal kick there. Ball drops to Lauren Friesen. Oh, nifty little move.
And there we go again. They're going to be on.
Coming out, looking to attack this left side. Frank cuts to his right foot, looking for the far post cross to the Buchanan striker. Alan Gonzalez challenging the keeper, but Fernando Uribe there again.
Yeah, the national team has turned it up, and they're winning all these loose balls now. They're winning the 50-50s. And
after going down 2-0, that's the kind of reaction you want
right.
to see.
Right, yeah, that's exactly what we wanted to see, and we knew that they were going to come out. It's just a little timing. And
again, looking for Elijah Rodriguez making that through run. Ball scooped up by Mount Whitney's Austin Aguiar. Just to quickly review, national team coached by Alan Fortune starting in a 4-3-3. As you can see, those three forwards really starting to put pressure on the American team's back line.
They're confusing them back there for sure.
How important is it for those three forwards to be interchangeable and move off of each other?
I think they have a great sense of where to be, where to move, and how to confuse that defender.
A little scoop pass. Man. He's in. Goal is in, but it is offside. It will not count.
Yeah, he was a step off, but it was a great play. Again, they're getting that movement there.
Arkelian thought he had the equalizer for a moment. Looked like the ball was from his Buchanan teammate, Diego Banda.
Yeah, but you got off good. I mean, you called it there. That those three forwards are confusing the defenders back there. They don't know how to defend that. They're all going in one direction, and then we got one that slips back.
The back four for the national team, Nathan Howard from Central High School at the left, Jose Hernandez from Golden West on the right, Austin Hathcote from Clovis North in the middle, alongside Josh De Los Santos from Visalia. Oh, sweet touch there from Alan Gonzalez. Brings it, dribbles out of a crowd. Head up looking for the pass. Finds Frank Delena on the wide. Checks it down to Central High's Nathan Howard. Cross blocked. Could it lead to another counterattack?
Mm-hmm.
Do you think the American team will be able to keep up that counterattack pace for the full 80 minutes?
I believe so. I mean, they're young, and they're going to be subbed out after halftime, so they're going to keep it up. And there it goes again.
Running again, we see another through ball. Aguiar has had to be very active, but it was offside either way.
Yeah, but they're still sticking to what the coaches were preaching, and they're still attacking the way they should, and that's good ball.
Those diagonal passes have really been a problem for the national team to handle. Arkelian's cross skies over, go out of bounds for an American team goal kick. Just to finish off the lineups for the national team, we have Lauren Friesen from Edison in the center mid alongside Diego Banda from Buchanan. In addition, Juan Carlos Lacazano from Central. While we're setting up for this goal kick, let's take this time to thank our sponsors, Jay Mora Consultants, Credit Life Solutions. Any issues with your credit, make sure you contact Jay Mora Consultants, Credit Life Solutions.
Oh, it looks like the player that just did the goal kick, I think he aggravated something.
It's coming up lame. Is he coming off to the side? No, looks like he's just coming to take that throw in. That is. Ball coming down this right-hand side. Can the American team unlock the doors? looking for the strike. National team defending with much more veracity than you saw in the first 10, 15 minutes.
Oh, good slide tackle. Good way to commit to the ball and not prevent that counter.
Starting to see a little taste of physical play now.
Yeah, this, which is what you want to see. I mean, as you know, there's never a scrimmage in soccer.
Yeah, friendly is just a friendly in name, right?
Nice.
As you see, a good example of that from Frank Delena storming in on the tackle. That a change at goalkeeper.
And I think you hinted on it earlier. I mean, he must have got hurt or pulled the groin or something. I mean, he's not taking the goal kicks and he was subbed out.
Yeah, you accept maybe a hip flexor, groin, yeah. Quad could all prevent you from taking those long kicks. So in now for the American team in net, Santiago Flores Escamilla, Roosevelt High School's goalkeeper. Immediately involved in the action on a pass back. Boots it upfield, 50-50.
Oh, good ball.
Ball lands at the feet of Banda. And again, Alan Gonzalez is not scared to strike the ball, is he?
No, he's not. And again, they took an opportunity, a new goalkeeper in. They want to see how his reflexes are.
Rob Van Binsberg is our center ref today. On the lines, we have Shelby Baird and Anthony Abbas. You expect much different from referees in an all-star game?
I would expect them to let them play and not like a high school game.
Let it flow a little
right.
Bit more.
A good another neat factor in this all-star game, it's not a traditional north-south. They're all integrated together, so you're going to have some Clovis kids with some Visalia kids and some Bakersfield kids with some Hanford kids, and that's a neat thing about this All-Star game.
I love seeing it. It really reflects the Valley. We're such
exactly.
A diverse culture.
Yes.
And again, now national team really looking to attack down that left side with plenty of through balls, and we're just going to hold it. Looks like there was some sort of injury on the field. Van Binsberg calling to the medical staff. You see who that injury is?
It was hard to tell. I think it was on that challenge.
Looks like maybe Raymond Torres, left mid from Selma. Take this opportunity to thank Central Valley Sports Report. Go check us out on www.cvsrgo.com. Excellent event. It's really important for the Central Valley that we continue to develop showcases like this.
Oh, I agree. And just from a year ago when we hosted this event and it was at Ratcliffe Stadium, where Fresno City's at, and now to be here, it's awesome. What a great event.
There's so much soccer talent here in the Central Valley.
I agree. It's a hotbed of talent, and just up and down the valley, I truly believe this could be start of something special, good with the Fresno Fuego here, and it's a lot of talent out here.
You see many of these guys with a future for the Fuego?
I do. I mean, I know Fresno likes to, the Fuego like to have a lot of their players from around here. There's a lot of talent. A lot of talent.
Looks like we get play restarted. American team again on the attack, looking to serve that ball into the far post.
Good.
Nathan Howard leaps well. He's one of those aggressive guys. He's relatively small in stature, about 5'6". I've never seen him back away from a header
right.
Tackle.
And he has some hops on him. And he showed it right there with that nice little header.
Jason Ruiz set to take the throw in. Nice flick on. Elijah coming in from the outside to try to attack it. Doesn't quite get to it. Ball cleared out of play. But you're right in terms of our Central Valley. Loving to see this mix. Because we've got so many different styles of play that can all come together and create an interesting brand.
Exactly. I mean, down in the South Valley, you know, your Farmersvilles, your Avenels, you're going to have a lot of speed and a lot of through balls. And up in the North Valley, it's a lot more technical and
long pass.
Yeah, long pass.
Taken care of by Christian Jimenez. And they'll swing it out wide left. Ball drops to Banda, looking for a through ball to his Buchanan teammate. Not quite long enough, but he does.
Comes
in with a crunching tackle. Can Delena get to the end of it? Controls it, settles it. Looking into the far post. Gonzalez leaping. Deals with it. Another great save, cleared off the line. Is that Jimenez on the clear there on the line?
Yes, it was. That was a heads-up play. He's seen his goalkeeper go up. He went back, and he was the last man. And great heads-up play.
Escamilla hadn't been in long, but immediately thrown into the fire. Little nimble feet. Ball knocked around, circulated. Lauren Friesen battling. Stripped to the ball. American team will immediately break. They've got a 2v2 opportunity. Another heavy switch.
Yeah.
Really a staple of Eric Solberg's strategies. Often known for his quick counters, looking to get the ball wide and attack early. And let's take a look at that replay as Jimenez stretches to clear it off the line, risking his body there for that one.
That was a great, great heads-up play. And he automatically seen what was going to happen. And just great heads-up play.
Great tactical awareness for a young guy there.
Yes.
Frank Delaney is one of those forwards that will lead you in tackles. It's a nightmare for defenders to play against. Not used to forwards putting that much pressure on.
Exactly.
Them.
You know, the change of pace, the ball movement.
Jimenez lofting the ball upfield. A little bit of confusion there from the national back line. Clearance goes to Lauren Friesen with the header. Ball eventually drops to Esteban Salgado. National team again looking to break. Banda sending it to Juan Carlos. Carlos barges through the back of Elijah Rodriguez. Referee says play on. Through ball. Can he get the cross in?
No.
It looks like Saldana's cross. Was that Saldana's or Sabatini? I couldn't quite see from here.
I believe it was Sabatini.
End-to-end, fast-paced play. It's hard to believe we're almost done with the first half. 33 minutes in the books.
Yeah, and again, they came out ready to play, which is good. Just the intensity, everything's up. I mean, most of these players know each other. They're probably rivals, and they might be on the same team, so they're going to want to win.
Big move there from Aguiar. American team collects the ball. Driving at defender, skips past one.
Oh, nice through ball.
Chip ball. The cross comes in.
Oh, just a bit wide.
Yeah. Difficult to hit that on the half volley there with the left foot.
Yeah. But again, that movement there has been there all first half.
Banda again on the ball. Looking for the outside shot. Escamilla sees it go wide.
Just what a great venue for these high school kids to be playing.
Oh, yeah. It's a beautiful surface, beautiful pitch, great atmosphere. Hopefully we see it continue to bring the best out of these guys. It's interesting, again, you see goalkeeper not taking the goal kicks. if Christian Jimenez has just decided to take that responsibility off of them.
Yeah, well, he has a pretty strong leg. I mean, he's been he's been reaching him out there.
You just wonder whether that might leave the back line out of position.
Exactly, and that's I'm not a big fan of that because of that. It leaves you essentially a man down.
Oh, sweet moves from the right back from the national team, Jose Hernandez.
Stepping
oh,
give
into
it
the
back
play.
To him.
He makes a good run. Allen holding on to the ball, weaving through defenders. Manages to stay on it. Oh, sweet little turn. He's bringing out all the tricks today, isn't he? Knocks it back to the fullback, Nathan Howard. Again, Howard, I think one of those players, like you said, a little bit out of position here
right.
with the All-Star game format. Normally see him in the center of a three-man back line. Today playing on the left of a four-man back line.
Yeah, that's really typical for a player, especially if it's changing the formation up and knowing exactly where to be.
American team on the break.
Oh, offside.
Just a little bit offside there. But as you were saying, what are the big differences between the four-man back line and three-man that players might need to adjust to?
Well, it's on their specific zones. I mean, if you're at a three-man back line, you're going to be I'll tell you in a minute.
Oh, national team again breaking. Ball falls to Banda. Great block there by the American team, and Escamilla scoops it up. Sends a quick counterattack. Ball held up. American team starting to play a little bit slower than you found in the
right.
first 20 minutes. Starting to play a little bit more side-to-side passing. Again, heavy tackle by Banda. Just skipped by Esteban Salgado again. Very nice on the touch. A couple Menachi players here in the starting lineup for the American team. Jonathan Vasquez in the middle, Luis Salazar on the left.
And again, that's another great squad up there in Porterville. All these All-Stars are great. You know, first-teamers, they're all leagues. And, you know, they're just all tremendous athletes and students.
Always love the intensity that you get from South Valley kids.
Exactly.
Don't
yeah.
back down from it.
Right.
Howard serves the ball in far post. Flores Escamilla just sees it out wide. On. Strong tackle. Some neat footwork in there. Comes out wide left. Some tricky skills. Finally sussed out. Jason Ruiz on the tackle, unable to keep it in bounds though. Finds the chest of Frank Delana. Comes outside to Lauren Friesen with a much better strike than his earlier one.
Yes. And he caught that ball, all of it. And that was a great shot.
It's like he caught just the outside of the laces. Let's take a look at the replay as Delana knocks it down. Sweet stroke, swinging out wide, and just a little bit too much swerve on that.
Yeah.
Flores Escamilla had to be at full stretch, though. There was no telling where that was going to go.
Right.
Battle for the ball there. Nathan Howard comes up with it. Sneaky moves there.
Oh, nice.
Diego Banda putting on a show today. These Valley Champion Buchanan boys look like they came to play.
Oh, man, what a year they had. What a year they had.
Cross comes in. Strong header. Falls to Lauren Friesen. He's had some good positioning for those second balls.
Yeah, they're really challenging the play. That was a good tackle, in my opinion.
I'd like to see a replay on that. I thought that was shoulder to shoulder
yeah.
from my angle. Maybe the referee saw something a little different.
Yeah, that's where you have to let them play. It was a 50-50 ball.
Frank nice, Delana comes in, maybe a little bit from behind, very aggressive. I've seen that called. I've seen it let play. Another aggressive ball leads to a goal. Check the linesman.
I think that goalie had the ball.
And the goal will stand. Austin Aguiar looked like he got his hands on it, but then it just spilled. Looked like a lot of contact in the box. You normally see referees protect the goalkeeper in that situation.
And he just made a 50-50 call, and now the goalie was touched on, and there was no call there.
The direct play from the American team has put the national team under pressure all day. As we take a look at the replay, heavy ball in. It looked like a fair play. Yeah. I didn't see much contact.
Yeah.
Just didn't quite get behind it. And that's big for momentum.
Oh, that was
just
huge.
1 minute before halftime.
Yeah, you're right. That's a huge momentum killer if they can get something here within the last few seconds.
They will try to break.
That's a nice corner.
You got a little cross come in, and it goes out of bounds for the national team corner. Will the referee let them play it? Looks like this will be the last chance of the half for the national team. Numbers coming forward. Ball served in.
Oh.
You got to beat that first defender on those crosses.
Yes. Yeah.
And that does it for the first half. Excellent play overall. Do you think that the national team will be able to come back and level the score in the second half?
I think so. In the middle of the first half, you see them dictating the game. They were dictating the tempo. But like you just mentioned right now, to give up a goal in the last few seconds of the half,
let's take a look again. This first goal, that was out of bounds. That might not have, that should not have counted.
Yeah.
But the American team, no complaints. They will take it.
No complaints.
And here's the second goal. Again, a long ball served in. Elijah Rodriguez, Sunnyside zone, breaks on it, holds the defender off, tucks it in.
That was just a great goal. That was all
great
effort.
Individual effort.
All effort.
National team's goal was much more of a team goal.
Yes. It started at the midfield.
Alan Gonzalez finishes the cross from Ryan Arkelian. We see some, a ferocious strike there. Lots of direct plays. You see, as we're looking at the replays, you see a lot of direct play, crosses, diagonal balls. Through ball, Aguiar was ready for that one.
For the most part, they gelled pretty well.
This was a great save. Yeah. That could have tied the game up.
That could have been the equalizer.
And another good strike from Lauren Friesen, just out wide. And here's the last goal. Very questionable. Excellent first half, and we'll be back after this short break here at Chukchansi Park.
The Video Production Academy at Sunnyside High School was founded in 2003. Over the years, the Academy has gone through many changes and continues to expand each year. The Video Production Academy is currently a 3-year program offering classes to sophomores, juniors, and seniors, with plans to add freshmen in the near future. Sophomores are enrolled in video production where they learn basic computer skills, camera operation, terminology, sound recording, and basic editing. Juniors take advanced video production, where they learn to shoot using DSLR cameras. Juniors learn every control and button on their cameras and have complete command of their final image. In addition, juniors learn Photoshop and have an introduction to special effects. Seniors choose one of two different pathways for their last year in the program. Some of the seniors choose to follow the broadcast pathway. The broadcast, or Daily Scratch, is led by Ms. McEwen. Sunnyside is one of the only high schools in the Central Valley to produce a daily broadcast. Every day, students write copy, load content into the switcher, and then produce a daily news program. The other pathway seniors can follow is cinematography with Mr. Weaver. In cinematography, students produce the pre-recorded content that is used by the Daily Scratch. Student reporters produce segments from events that are happening on campus and in the community. Cinematography students utilize Hollywood tools and techniques to tell their stories. Video Academy students partner up with CMAC, Community Media Access Collaborative, to produce content for broadcast television. This football season, the video production students at Sunnyside are responsible for broadcasting 3 football games. The video crew is entirely comprised of students and will be broadcast live on 2 cable channels as well as on the internet. While the academy is strongly focused on video production skills, we also pride ourselves on preparing college and career-ready graduates. Our aim is to prepare every student for a 4-year university. Here is a sampling of some of our work.
Players are all set. Referees just checking the goalkeepers. And we'll start the second half with a bunch of changes.
And again, we're all having new, it's a whole new roster for both sides. If you have an athlete
looking to go to that next level, make sure you check out their website, cgsgo.com. Like the Fresno Fuego, the Fresno Freeze, Chukchansi Park, J. Moore Consultants, Credit Life Solutions, Ideas Plus, Fresno Coin Gallery, Sincal Cosmos, McCarty Insurance, Sweet Bees Catering, CMAC, Sunnyside. A national team building up the right side. Looks like they got Danny Lopez on the right side of the midfield now. You'll recognize him. He's the one wearing black shorts. And it looks like the national team's going to stick with their 4-3-3 and American team staying with their 4-4-2. Jose Barraza from Madera South is now in nets for the national team. Already a lot of different players, gonna change the tempo of the game.
And then you're going to see it just like in the first half. They're going to take about, about 5-7 minutes to really know the speed of how they're going to play and what players they want to have combination with.
Solomon Saleh in the middle. Looks like Alan Gonzalez still on the ball. What do you think of Solomon Saleh?
Oh, I love it. I mean, I'm being biased here. I coach the guy, but I think he's a great talent, and you see it right now. He's the main focal point of that offense right now, center mid, and he's dishing that ball out pretty well. Really quick. He's a great, great ball handler.
Also added Eric Ormonde from San Joaquin Memorial out on the left side. As the ball goes out for a goal kick.
I'm wondering if one of these goalkeepers have the sun in their eyes, and it might be a factor, but I can't really tell.
And I think that did factor into the Aguiar miss in the first half.
Right.
Oh, silky moves there.
Mm-hmm.
American team looking to combine. Make sure I see David Omi from Clovis North. Big, powerful center forward. Got some good moves on the ball. How's he going to be able to impact the tempo of play with these other all-stars on the field?
He'll know really, really quick if, you know, the style of play, the way he wants to dictate the tempo. A nice dish outside.
Ball cut out, sent up. Omi holding up, twisting, turning. Looking to build it up the right-hand side. Sam Martin from Bullard High School cuts it back. Looking for the left-footed cross.
For the most part, you see the national team with the ball more. They're being more the aggressor. They're possessing the ball well.
Yeah, national team definitely off to a good start in the second half. See if they can maintain it. See if this good start could lead to a goal, perhaps. Bounces again, national team keeping under pressure. Trey Center cuts it out, looking for the slide rule pass. Nice eventually finds Omi. Keeper coming out. Had to come up big there.
Nice. Oh, see, again, I think that was a nice little.
Barasa, Madera South came out early, aggressive. Is that what you want to see from your keeper there?
Yeah. I expected him to lob it over him as he was, you know, trying to break away from him, but he kicked it right to the keeper.
Yeah, it looked like he was bouncing just that right height for a chip. All passed around through the midfield. Trey Center cutting into the left foot. Just seems to scuff the ground a little bit on that. Is that Solomon there?
No, Solomon's the one, the orange.
The yellow boots?
Yeah.
Ball comes out. Danny Lopez cutting to the inside, looking for that right-hand strike.
He's trying to. There it is.
Finally tees it up. Intercept there by Adam Carrillo. Ball played through the midfield. Ooh, heavy slide and tackle there. Trey Center from Clovis North. Cutting inside. They get it up top early.
Looked like he was sliding the second base there. But that was a good
good tackle, good contest.
Again, you love to see it because so many times you see All-Star games and there's no defense, players are just letting each other run by. But this All-Star game definitely has some bite.
Yeah, and that there it is right there. He just went. It's good. I mean, it's no harm, no foul. But you know, they like the physicality. You know, it's nothing.
And if there isn't at least one or two fouls, you're probably not playing very hard.
Right, right. Those are called lazy, lazy fouls.
Sal Yanez here likes to play short. A little bit of pressure there. They work out of it. Yanez puts the big ball in. Aronde looking to find some space. Fighting off the defenders. Finally knocks it back. Like Alexis Osasuna. Is that Osasuna in the yellow boots there?
Yes. And the national team is, they came out the aggressor. I don't know what, I can imagine what coach told them, you know, being down 3-1 at half. And you know, for the most part, they might.
And that's track speed right there from Martin. You see him open up. He's a 400 meter. Wow. And he sends a beautiful cross in, just unable to get to it.
Yeah.
He's on his way to play at Westmont this fall. I think he'll be a good addition to the team.
You could just see the speed right off the bat.
400-meter runner, long jumper. He could play anywhere across the back line. Very effective player there.
Yeah, I expect him to contend for playing time right away. I mean, you can't teach speed.
No, that's true. Clocked at about a 4.6 40-yard dash, which is NFL combine time for, you know, solid linebacker safety speed. American team, again, coming up this left side. Good physical play there, Adam Carrillo.
Wow.
Getting stuck in.
And see, when you don't have the line judge waving the flag for a foul.
Yeah, Adam Carrillo, Tulare Western.
There it is, they're getting. So I can already tell that Fresno City coach already messaged the team, hey, let's go attack the right defender spot. And that's two times in a row already. Where,
you know, Solberg's a big fan of the German and English brand of soccer.
Yes.
You know, so he loves to attack out wide along the wings, fast-paced, entertaining brand of soccer.
And he has that speed there where he can open it up in space now.
Competitive tackles there on this right side. Good hustle there, Danny Lopez, getting stuck in. American team building it up the left, looking for the short pass. Aggressive sliding tackle there. Harrison Smith Memorial. Cross comes in. Goalkeeper deals well with it. National team will try to build out of the back.
Yeah,
Douglas.
I was talking with Coach Fortune before the game, and he said that seven of his players that are slated to go to West Hills are on his other side, so he's not having his players with him.
Oh, that's an interesting dynamic to the match. Oh, quick counter opportunity. Danny Lopez immediately in behind. Well recovered. American defense get three guys back behind the ball. Ball's dished to Allen. Allen again showing his twisting, turning, holding off defenders, but eventually loses the ball.
That was a beautiful ball. Beautiful ball.
It's going to be difficult to counter with only one or two attackers.
Exactly.
Though.
But like you called it, that those defenders all came back in unison and just trapped them really well and forced a turnover.
Oh, there he goes again.
Allen in a one-on-one. Beats the first defender, second defender. There's really been committed team defense from the American team in the second half, trying to hold on to that 3-1 lead.
Right, and they probably challenge each other to not let it go and to work together. And
oh, if a national team can score one more and make it 3-2, it'll right. really change the face of
Everything
this game.
Everything changes. And usually you'll see the in an all-star game, you'll see all the goals score on a quarter because of that communication factor.
Yes, it's much more the goalkeeper has to take a lot of responsibility. Oh, and the shot goes sailing wide. And it'll be out of bounds for a goal kick. So, Solomon, you say he's best in that attacking mid-roll?
Yeah, he's a great attacking mid. He's a great finisher, but he just sees the field. He has a great vision for the game. And you already seen him around now with the touches he had. He's distributed the ball well.
He's on his way to play for Coach Fortune at West Hills, huh?
Yes. That's what he says now. I mean, a lot of things can change from now to September, August, September. But I think he'll be a great addition.
Fortune's doing a good job rebuilding the program.
He's doing a great job.
He's brought in a lot of overseas guys. They had, I think, 10 Brazilians.
Yeah, they had a lot of them. I mean, I think they're the Brasilia. But no, he had, I mean, I was chopping it up with him, and he had a great, great team this year. They went 17-5-2. They went far into the playoffs this year.
Love those local rivalries. Fresno City's had the upper hand for years and years
right.
and years. West Hill's trying to close the gap, though.
Yeah, and I think it's really close.
Yes, definitely, especially when you compare it to in years past.
Right. While they're doing a goal change, we're going to do a quick shout out to our sponsors, Central Valley Sports Report, and that's www.cbsrgo.com. That's cbsrgo.com. They're putting on a great event here, Chukchansi. We got a DJ going on. There's a lot of music, a lot of people in attendance. And then they get capped off with the Fresno Fuego game after our game, and it's just a great, great thing for our kids. As we see the midfield trying to keep possession with the ball, the American team trying to score once more. Great ball, shot, deflected.
It just goes out of bounds. That'll be a corner kick
another
for the American team.
Another corner for the American team, and they're on the attack again. They want another. They want to score some more. And now you do see that sun in his eye. Oh, nice little
in swinging corner. Just hits the roof of the net. Be a goal kick for the national team. Harrison Smith looking for the short one. Barraza decides to go long.
Quick through ball down the right side. And
Danny Lopez gets to the edge of it.
Oh,
cuts
nice.
It in.
Nice save.
Well done. Ball falls to Alan Gonzalez. It bounces. Strikes Ooh. It with the left, and it just goes out just wide. Had a lot of power on
it
that
did.
Left foot strike.
Goal
kick for the American team.
Just a bit off, but it was a great shot.
Ball goes up to Omi, holding off a defender, just loses out. Second half play, not quite as fluid as the first half.
Not quite, but you're seeing a lot more possession with both teams, and they, you know, they're really moving the ball well, which is good. You know,
here's Jose Tovar building it for the American team. Crunching tackle, and it looks like the referee's pointing for a national team free kick, even though it's an American team player on the ground. Oh, he changed his mind.
If that sun gets in that keeper's eye, it's going to be a problem.
They'll serve it in.
There it
is. Again, just as you predicted, will it end up in the net?
Almost.
Not quite. Not quite. That ball could have spilled anywhere.
Yeah.
As soon as you saw the keeper trying to block the sun, you know he's taking his eyes off the ball slightly.
I'd say the intensity stepped up more so than the first half now. Maybe it's because they're down 3-1 or...
Yeah, definitely seeing American team trying to finish this game off with that right-footed strike, and it just goes wide from Jose Arellano.
It's another corner. I think that's their fourth corner, third or fourth corner already this half. Oh, we can get a quick counter here.
They've got a two-on-two opportunity in front. American team smothers that attack. And again, national team looking to break. Sending up to Eric Ormande.
Nice switch of field by the national team.
Harrison Smith sends that one in. That's going to be easy for a keeper like Peter Larson.
Right.
Peter Larson, Bullard High goalkeeper, last 3 years. On his way to UCLA. Tovar looking for the reverse pass to Trey Senna. He gets to it. They serve the cross in. Just a little bit too high. Ball falls to Omi. And now the strike from the left side goes straight to the keeper.
Yeah, it looked like a little bit of undecisiveness by the players.
Rogelio Luviano to Larry Union. I thought he was going to bang that far post. Yeah. A little hesitation. But I saw from Madeira South has looked good in nets in the second half. Yeah, the one play where he got lost in the sun, but outside of that, dealing with things. Ball comes outside. Through ball, American team on the counter, looking for the cheeky back heel. Doesn't come off. Here's Alexis Asuna out to Danny Lopez. Attacking with pace on that one-on-one. Cuts it back. What's he going to find? Checks it down to Suleiman. Nice first touch. Skips pass. Brings it back down. As you said, a much more patient attack in the second half.
Right. They're, you know, they know that in that possession, they're not going to get scored on. But they got to find a way to make some through balls, some goal runs. Yeah,
they're just looking for the keys to unlock this American defense. Got a couple substitutes coming in here for the American team. Everybody get up.
This is the home opener today for the Fresno Fuego. What a great event.
Also, Fantastic day for sports.
Oh, yeah. Where do we start?
You got the Kentucky Derby, the Mega Fight, these two All-Star games. Snapshot by the national team cleared out. The NFL draft continues. We got a Game 7 going on in the NBA playoffs. What more could you ask for as a sports fan?
Right.
And then the highlight of the day, of course, Fuego kicks off against the Missioneros.
Yeah, you see that these players with the national team, they're gelling more so than the first half group right now.
Definitely in the midfield area.
Right,
I thought in the first half, the three forwards of the national team were very dynamic.
Yes.
This half, the midfielders are really starting to take
control. If those three forwards were in with these batch of mid, it would have been a different story.
You can see the interchangeability of all the players as Larson looks to restart the attack. Playing out to the left for Alexis Rivera. Ball eventually spills to Omi.
Oh, there it is.
So a nice heavy first touch. The left foot is strike.
Just wide.
By Angel Gutierrez to Larry Union zone.
And even the coaches are a little, you know, the gamership, they do want to win. I was with Fresno City coach before the game, and he talked about how he wants to win. Anytime he can beat West Hills in anything, it's going to be good.
Well, it's becoming a real local rivalry.
Yes.
And real competition for players. Competition for stature.
Yeah, they're both recruiting the same type of players. I mean, just in this game alone, they're, you know, most of these players are going to be playing.
Center
with
picks up the ball, sprays a beautiful diagonal pass, awkward dealt with, and that unfortunately will be an own goal.
Own goal. And you're going to have that with the miscommunication. You see the goalkeeper going up, probably towing the back off, but he headed it at the last second.
And that's going to happen when you get those dangerous crosses coming in, putting back lines under pressure. That'll take the score to 4-1. That's going to make it really difficult for the national team to come back.
They're
going
to have to start scoring some quick goals if they're going to want to be in this game.
Looks like we might have an injury there for the American team. Somebody's walking towards the sideline.
If it wasn't for these little mistakes, I mean, we're looking at a 1-1 game. You know, the questionable goal that was out of bounds, the other one just before halftime, and then you have this one where, for the most part, the national team had possession, had the ball, and just this little break here, and they get a quick own goal.
Not normally do you say a 4-1 game has been really close.
Right, right.
But I think you'd be accurate in saying that today. Jose Tovar. Holding off defenders, shrugging them off. Binsberg eventually calls the foul. And Justin Bieber. Jose Tovar played the attacking mid for Bullard. Also can play a deeper midfielder. As you say, a lot of these guys have a lot of versatility.
Right.
Barasa had been having a very good second half until that little bit of a miscommunication with the back line.
And most of these players are the alpha dog in their teams, you know. So to be in a big, you know, pond like this where everyone's the alpha dog, I mean, that takes a lot of communication. And
there's two parts of communicating, right? The talking and the listening.
Right.
And again, Sam Martin, you see the track speed opening up down that right side, cutting in, holding off a couple defenders, drops a pass back, Omi on the ball, holding off defenders.
No one there.
Cross swings in. And that's the trouble when you have your center forward dropping deep to collect it.
Yes.
Then who are you going to aim for?
Right.
How How do you see the game evolving in the Central Valley? I know we talked about the history of it in the Fresno and Central Valley area. Is it changing as the years go along?
I think it is. It's just more, I mean, having the Fresno Fuego here is a big plus. Maybe having one in a down south, you know, Hanford, Visalia, having another team, that's the way it's going to grow.
Cross comes in, bounces out wide. Luviano serves the cross back in the center with a snap header.
Good play.
Yeah, Barasa was all over that one, looking to make amends for that earlier mistake.
I mean, you just see the talent alone. I mean, there's talent to go on forever, but we need these types of events so that the game could grow. I mean, when we have these Mexican clubs that come here, they're sold out here. They're sold out anywhere they come here. And that speaks because of the fan base there is. You know, they just love their soccer here.
You know, I've heard a lot of people argue that soccer has supplanted baseball as the number one sport in the Central Valley. What would be your take on that?
I would disagree. I mean, just the fact that we're you know, the soccer community as a whole is getting these. You know, you can get national teams. You can get – I remember in 94, the Mexican national team came to Bulldog Stadium. I mean, you get these powerhouse teams to come in here. You get Club America. You had Club León just recently here to packed venues that were sold out very quickly. It's
nice series of moves there by Jose Tovar. Continue.
Yeah, it speaks volumes. I think we have the most loyal fans, and they follow you – it just needs to get more out there. And I think by having this event here now shows it a little bit more. And this is just high school. Fresno Fuego had a good game against the Sacramento Republic. And it was the Battle of the 99, the Derby. And that was a big event here.
And that was just like today, very end-to-end open match, a lot of attacking, a lot of goals.
You know, and Sacramento is a finalist to have an MLS team now. So who's to say that Fresno can't have an MLS team or at least a
– Luviano with a nice move there. Bringing it back, working through the midfield.
Oh, nice.
And the Memorial fullback clears that. Tovar with a tackle. Nice little herky-jerky move to glide past two players.
Nice.
Those simple moves often are the most effective.
Right.
As we break for this substitute during the throw-in, let's take a moment and thank some of our sponsors, Food Max, Walmart, Vons, and Good Times Cafe in the Sierra Vista Mall. All helped to make this event possible.
Yeah, I mean, you hit it there with all these sponsors. Everyone put in for this great event.
Ball goes out of bounds. Linesman hesitated, but eventually called it goal kick. A couple other sponsors I don't want to forget to mention. MB2 Raceway in the Sierra Vista Mall, Yosemite Falls Cafe, Red Carpet Car Wash, Target, Barnes & Nobles, and Enterprise Rent-A-Car. 10 minutes left in the match. Been end-to-end. You think we got one more goal left in it?
I think we got a couple. We got to get a couple more.
We got a lot of options for MVP of today's match. Elijah Rodriguez really lit it up in the first half. Jorge Saldana was also very deadly in the first half. Second half, we've had a couple decent performers. I don't know if anybody stood out in the second half quite the way Rodriguez did in the first half.
The first half, Rodriguez just put on a good show and showcase, you know, the talents that he has.
And he'll also be on his way to Fresno City College next year. Long line of good players from Sunnyside that have gone through Fresno City's ranks.
Right, yeah. Sunnyside's have come up big time the last five, six years.
Especially with midfield players, mm-hmm. I've noticed a lot of attack-minded midfielders, wingers. Victor Amarillas comes to mind. As the national team still looking to press on, still looking to find that extra goal in it. One of the things you notice maybe with this national team, seeing a few of the Memorial players that like to play a very direct game, trying to combine with some of the other players that are playing more of a small passing technical game.
And that's the beauty of this All-Star game. You're going to have, you know, those types of schemes, schematic, you know, play that they're just so different, and the way they gel is pretty neat to see.
Ball coming back to Cooper Douglas. Again, another Memorial defender. Looks to find that short pass to Sullivan. Comes out wide right. Adam Carrillo. Fullback bombing forward. Oh, looking for the fancy footwork there. Nathan Howard has returned for the national team.
Yeah, I think you're going to be seeing that fatigue in right now if they've been running.
Yeah, it's okay having open subs, but when you're playing this fast-paced a game, there's going to be some fatigue. Throwing comes, Howard again with the header. Good battle there. Americans look to counter. David Omi just been struggling to hold on to the ball last couple plays.
He has. I don't know if fatigue's going to be that or.
Player with his size, fatigue is always going to be an issue. Fitness is always going to be more difficult for those more heavy built players. And national team, again, looking for the quick counter. A great slide tackle there.
The American defense has been really, really good.
Commitment is a word that might come to mind.
Yes, they're very committed.
Once again, ladies and gentlemen, the conclusion of our All-Star game. Make sure you stick around. As you can catch the Fresno Fuego. Once again, we'd like to thank our sponsor, Central Valley Sports Report, CVSRGO.com. The Fresno Fuego and the Fresno Freeze.
National team with the opportunity to serve one in. Hopefully pull one goal closer as we're entering the last 6 or 7 minutes of the contest. Pete Larson from Bullard High School organizing his wall, setting up his defenders, making sure everyone's marked. There is a free man for the national team if they could take advantage. A free man moving near post. Instead, they like to go far post.
Far post.
Well, wide. And again, the cross comes in. Larson sees it go wide.
You're going to have that type of set piece in this type of game. I mean, there's not that much communication there, and they don't know what to do. But, I mean, if you're in that position, you want to at least go for goal. And it can ricochet off a post, off a defender.
And American team will start it with a short free kick from the goal kick. How important is it for the modern goalkeeper to be good with his feet?
Oh, it's really important because it's not just using your hands now. I mean, you gotta get to where that ball's gonna be placed. So you got to, you know, be, as they say, have to have that jumpy type of feet where you're on your toes at all times. And if you're not quick, if you have slow reflexes, you're going to have trouble.
Frank Delena back in on that right side for the national team. Hoping to provide a spark for these last few minutes. Oh, nice little run. He's facing one-on-one, facing up. Little dance move.
Nice.
Finds Omi at the top. Cuts one, cuts two. Looking for the left foot shot. And it's blocked and trickles through to the goalkeeper.
That was good vision. I mean, he ran down the seam and then he paused and looked up and found a trailing center mid.
Goalkeeper tries the cheeky chip pass. Doesn't quite come off. Sam Martin unable to collect it. Oh, here we go. game just kind of slowly ambling towards a conclusion now.
Yeah, not that much firepower left in the second half as was in the first half.
Overall, good soccer. Maybe not quite as intense with the American team taking that fourth goal. Kind of took a little bit of the fire out the game.
Yeah, it sure did. Up to that point, you know, you see it that the national team had movement. And we'll see. We got to take a shot here. A nice little roller.
Sam Martin collecting the ball, recirculating it through the back line, where it's David Gomez and Rob Morrow from Clovis and Clovis East. Lopez has been pacey.
Oh.
Comes Solomon, goes for there a toe poke and tucks it away in the side net. I think he called it early. He said he was going to make an impact. Just as he said, comes through with a nice little toe poke finish, just gets it around the keeper. Peter Larson unable to keep it out.
That was good movement also to get him to that ball. I mean, it was all hustle play, but all the – it was a – it started off in midfield. Solomon Soleil.
Ladies and gentlemen, can I please have
– It started with the off-the-ball movement there.
Yeah.
And please head over to the slide.
And as we wait for the replay, let's take a look at some of the action. National team – cut it to two. See how aggressive they can as Nathan Howard comes down the right side, finding Lopez, who's battling again. And we take a look at that replay as Solomon tucks it away. Did very well to get to that in a crowd.
Yeah.
Normally, you'd think that the guy of a smaller stature might have got pushed off, but right. Very tough in there. Looks like he might have some of that wiry strength, huh?
Right, yeah. That's a great analogy. Yeah, he does. Just a real knack for the net.
It's been a good battle today. Both teams come to play as Tovar collects it, sends a left-footed through ball. Again, Omi battling. Gets away with a little forearm shiver.
It's a big rambling.
Sends the ball out to center. Unable to control it.
You got to love that effort, though, man. He wants that ball. No one's going to take it away. And
he's a handful. You know going against him, you're in for a battle. Tovar sizing up. Oh, cuts
nice.
Past Howard. Going for the left-foot cross. Keeper deals with it. And then Cooper Douglas clears it out of bounds for an American throw. Tovar and Nathan Howard going at it there. Two club teammates again. Now face against each other in the All-Star match. Always interesting to see those unique battles.
Right.
Long throw in comes, but Asa able to deal with it. Booming kick goes up to Frank Delena, hustling it down. Alexis Rivera clears it out. And that will end our match with the American team winning by a score of 4-2. Excellent overall match.
Yeah, it was a great show. Great show, great soccer. Such a great event.
Let's take a look at some of the highlights here as we see that last second clearance by Cooper Douglas from Memorial High School. Helped to keep the score line close at the end. Here we're seeing the long through ball. This is the first goal of the match that highly questionable. As you can see, the linesman not quite in a position to call it, but Saldana does well to finish it. This, the highlight of the game.
Yes.
Elijah Rodriguez controls it, holds off the defender. Sweet left-footed finish.
Yeah, that was just all effort again. I mean, I can't express how much it looked, you know, beautiful.
National team brought the game back close with that goal from Alan Gonzalez.
Yeah, great.
Looked like they could have tied it up with this strike.
Yeah, this is a game changer right here. Where this is a game changer right here for the national team. You know, they go up 2-2, but that instinct by that defender just cleared it away.
Yeah. Very fast pace. As you can see, a lot of the highlights from the first half were based off of long passes, direct play.
This is a play right here.
Excellent clearance. Again, that could have changed the game.
This is a nice rifle shot here.
Lauren Friesen's shot goes just wide. And there's the goal that finished the first half and really put the American team on the forefront. Flick coming in. Barasa dealt with that one well. Peter Larson stretches out to get that save. Long throw in comes in. Flick. Peter Larson ready for the save. That was the header from Trey Senna. Barasa again doing well. For a game that was 4-2, the goalkeepers also played well.
Yes. And it's difficult for the keepers because they don't have their defense. They don't have their guys. That just shows their leadership, you know, their instinct.
Overall, great match, entertaining end-to-end soccer. Once again, signing off, this is Onesta Francis alongside Eric Barbosa. Thanks for tuning in, and we'll see you next year.